Hello. In this video, I'm going to walk you through logging into Google, navigating to Google Classroom, and creating your first Google Classroom from scratch. Let's get started. From a google.com window of any kind, I'm in Chrome, but you could be in Safari or somewhere else, I'm going to navigate to google.com. I'm going to go up to this blue button in the right-hand corner and sign in. This is where I'm going to put in my username and password. Now that I've done that, I know that I'm signed in and confirm that I'm signed in because up in this top icon circle here, I'm either going to see my profile picture that I've added there, or I'm going to see an initial. I can click on it and I can see which account I've signed into as well. That's getting into google.com. Now I'm going to navigate to Google Classroom. I have two options for navigating to Google Classroom. I could type Google Classroom in the browser and navigate down to Google Classroom. Boom, I'm here. Or I could have used the app launcher. The app launcher lets me have access to all sorts of my Google tools. Google Classroom is one of them. If you haven't used Google Classroom in the past, you may need to scroll down to the bottom to access it. Select on it. And again, we've arrived at the Google Classroom navigation page. You will see up at the top right-hand corner is a plus button. This is how I'm going to create my first class from scratch. As I select on the plus button, I have two options, join class or create class. This allows an educator to join other teachers' classes for professional development or for collaboration. If you do not see both options, please reach out to your district administrator and make sure that they have put you in the teacher bucket of Google Classroom. Students will only see join classroom. So I'm going to go ahead and come back. We're going to push the button and create the class. When we select create the class, we have some options here. I need to give it a name. I caution you to be very specific, so I'm going to put something like Womble 2020-21 school year, because maybe I'm teaching an elementary class. This might be more specific if you're a high school. In this section, I might say period 2. In the subject, let's say we're going to do AP Biology. And then this room number. This could be my physical room number, or this could be a link to my online class outside of Google Classroom. So it could be my Zoom link or my Google Meets link or what other thing that you think of. Down in the bottom right-hand corner, I have the button create. And it's telling me it's creating, which I love. So I don't think that my computer is stalling and dying. I know it's working in the background to create that class for me. It can take a little bit. It looks like it's taking a little longer than normal. And there we go. Now it has come up with my title here. I have my period here. And I can come over here to the left-hand side and navigate back to the window where I created a class before and continue creating classes. So now that we've walked through that, it's your turn. I'd like you to try logging into Google, accessing Google Classroom, and creating your first sandbox course to use within this module. If you have any questions, please add them to the discussion thread and keep working hard.